Hello, this is Geoffrey Fox here, reporting for the FutureGrid team. I'm going to give you an overview of this NSF Exceed system, which is a computing testbed as a service. And we will have special emphasis on the cloud features, although FutureGrid covers both cloud and high-performance computing environments. So, FutureGrid is, as I've already mentioned, part of the National Exceed system, and it is a testbed with a cloud focus, and it covers grids and HPC as well. It has been operational since summer of 2010, so it's essentially been running for 3 years now. And what does it provide its users? It provides support of both computer and computational science, namely not only fundamental technologies, but also their application. Although as the machines are not large, it doesn't tend to do as much production domain science as the other Exceed systems. It has a flexible development and testing platform for middleware and application users. And the types of things people are looking at on FutureGrid, as I say, not really production, although there is quite a bit of that. They're looking at interoperability, functionality of software, performance of software, or they're evaluating different approaches. Should you look at Hadoop at your local university, you can try it out first on FutureGrid. FutureGrid is, unlike most of the Exceed systems, a very relatively fixed but highly optimized and robust environments. It is user customizable. It's accessed interactively. The software is often slightly flaky because most cloud software is, in fact, pretty flaky at the moment. And as I said, it supports grid, cloud, and HPC software. You can run with or without virtual machines. And you can, in fact, test the same software on the same hardware with and without virtual machines. It is very useful for education, and it offers a rich environment for supporting classes, tutorials, and things like that. It has many environments, such as MPI for high-performance computing, but also the main open-source virtual machine management systems, OpenStack, Eucalyptus, Nimbus, are directly supported. OpenNebula is used on FutureGrid, as in fact is CloudStack. We hope to soon move to a more systematic approach involving software-defined systems so that you can retarget hardware to very different software environments at a click of a button. If you look at the use types of FutureGrid, there are four major use types, and those are dominantly computer science and middleware, 51%. That's as of July 3rd, 2013. That's core computer science and cyber infrastructure work, namely very fundamental work, but also a lot of applied work, such as developing the software used on Exceed. These use types come from 318 approved projects with 1,860 users. And those are interestingly distributed, 77% from the USA. Then we have Puerto Rico, Indonesia, and Italy, between 2 and 3%. Those ratios are high because we've had several classes from those countries. And those are followed by India, China, and the United Kingdom. And the users come from industry, government, and academia, with the academia, not surprisingly, the largest users. After computer science, we mentioned interoperability, which tends to be done by computer scientists. And though it's only a small percentage, 3%, it's a very important aspect. And typical thing we do there is support endpoints with various standards, such as the OGF or Open Grid Forum standards. We have 22% doing domain science, various applications. Of those 22.4%, we have exactly half at the moment in life science and non-life science, 11.2% each. We have a pretty significant training education outreach, 14.4%. I noticed that that's fraction is fraction of projects. The education projects have the largest number of associated people, like because they have students, and we've had up to 200 students in a single class. So that 14.4% probably underestimates the impact on FutureGrid, because those students don't use much time, and indeed not many users of FutureGrid use huge amounts of time. They have maybe quite a lot of stress on the system support. And the final activity area is systems evaluations. That includes the exceed testing and also other national and international activities, such as the Open Science Grid and the European Grid Initiative on various campuses. So that's 8.8%. So that's the makeup of FutureGrid. And it has changes a little from month to month, but it's been sort of like this, largest computer science, roughly equal domain, roughly equal life science and non-life science, and significant education and evaluation throughout its operation. Notice life science is probably higher than some other computers. That's possibly because life science has a lot more new software to be developed. if you go to Amazon, you load your image onto a virtual machine. But FutureGrid has a slightly different model, namely you provision the environment and then you load your software on it. So that means we can actually use bare metal or virtual machines, namely hypervisors, on the same hardware and switch our hardware back and forth. This tends to be done in a relatively fixed fashion at the moment at the discrete points of time. But as I mentioned in the beginning, we're moving to software-defined environments where you'll be able to dynamically provision within a few minutes on different basic environments. Then we have various, obviously, image libraries for standard software, MPI, OpenMP, MapReduce, the grid softwares of various sorts. We have a ScaleMP, distributed shared memory environment. And we have also Windows supported on one of our machines. And of course, the growth of this system comes from users depositing novel images into our library. Notice the FutureGrid is quite small. It has just 4,700 distributed cores, and it has a network that is dedicated, with one small exception, Texas, which does not have a dedicated link. So the sort of model is you have a library with a bunch of images, and those effectively include the core environment, namely bare metal, no virtualization or virtualization, and you load that on your machine and you run. Here is a rather dense slide with actually the hardware on them, FutureGrid, and if we start at the top, our most used machine, which is the largest, is with 256 CPUs, is India. That's at Indiana University. And the next largest is Alamo, which is at Texas. And then that's a Dell machine there, India. And also smaller machines, hotel at Chicago, Sierra at San Diego, and Foxtrot at Florida. Those are all IBM iDataplexes with various numbers of CPUs. X-Ray is a reasonably big machine. It is a small Cray XT5M that is at Indiana University. Then we have a bunch of small machines with special characteristics. Originally, we tried to support all these different characteristics on the same set of hardware, but we found that just too complicated. So we have three machines with a lot of memory, Bravo, Delta, and Echo, each with 32 CPUs. They each have also large amounts of disk. They have 12 terabytes of disk each, for every server. Delta is, has Tesla, NVIDIA GPUs. And Echo is equipped to run the Scale MP software. We have one other specialized machine, Lima, which is for testing SSDs, and that's at the San Diego Supercomputer Center. So if you add all that up, you should see there are around 4,700 cores, excluding the GPUs. Formerly, the total performances are really very modest these days, 55 teraflops. The memory is quite good. Because we have a lot, we have these large memory machines, Bravo, Delta, and Echo, and the secondary storage is actually getting up there now. After we've added a lot of secondary storage on again those specialized machines, the reason to have the specialized storage is partly to support experiments with Hadoop and the associated file system, Hadoop file system, HDFS, which. Puts the disk, the storage on the nodes themselves. So to allow better support of that, we got those machines with significant disks. We also increased the disk size on the India machine to make it more effective for people's use. FutureGrid is a 4-year project, and it has one more year to run, and it has the several partners. Indiana's the lead. And the partners shown in red on this slide are the ones with hardware, San Diego. They had Sierra and Lima. Chicago, it has the Machine Hotel. Florida has the Machine Foxtrot. And TAC, Texas at Austin, has the Machine Alamo. We have other partners. USC, ISI doing software, especially workflow. Virginia, which is working with Exceed and also looking at standards. And Tennessee, which is doing benchmarking.